Hello everybody and welcome back to Anno 1800, looking at our beautiful little Rosario that we have now with engineers as well. So right here in the city center with the theater that we have there, university, and our first engineers. Now, I wanted to finish my steel production. Thank you for the advice, by the way, that I have to, of course, put a fire station here. I think one will not be enough for the whole thing, because, of course, they're also reducing the risk of fire. So I should probably squeeze in another fire station for this district, since we got so many factories here. Another thing that we have in Caton right now is the workforce problem. So we are at 250 workers. So what I would like to do is getting rid of workers, but, of course, only temporarily. So we're going to upgrade a few more of those guys. As long as I still have some timber. And then I will add a school. So school is something they still need. And of course, it's a need. And the higher the need is, the more workers are going to live here. So a school is what I should add. And of course, a school also just looks very nice. And we might also have, well, a few ornaments there in the form of trees around the school. A little playing ground, perhaps. And as we can see, the worker workforce is increasing, so from 110 to 94, so we helped a bit there, but of course not very much. The only thing is that we do need a few more additional farmers. We are going to solve these problems soon though with the workforce, because we have finally unlocked the commute pier. So the only thing that I would really love there and need is the reinforced concrete. So this is something that we're going to add now soon. Oh, yeah, and as we can see, we now have a positive workforce. Oh, some very brave pirate is trying something here in the Garden of Sin. And yes, he also shows me that I only have one defense tower. Is that right? We should have some more weapons here, don't we? Yes, 29 weapons. Oh, the bricks are missing, right? We don't even have the clay here yet. So let's build a clay pit there in the Garden of Sin. It's a small switch to what I actually wanted to do, but still, of course, we need to do it at some point. And let's add, and there we have an oil patch or an oil spring, so I cannot do anything there. And as we can see, oh yes, of course, we would need some obreros. So instead of that, let's build, first of all, a clipper here. And then we will, first of all, also have the repair crane here that I wanted to build for quite some time now. And then we can deliver the bricks there to the Garden of Sin. Now, we have the school, we have the workers again, some farmers are coming in as well. That is all fine. The only thing that's missing here now is, well, another trade route. Without that, we cannot continue. We have, let's see, we have quite a lot of furnaces here that are now working really, but we don't have any iron ore, right? We have only one iron deposit, and this is something that we need to change. So, in Rosario, where we, by the way, also have a quest that we should have a look at. I've seen all there is to see, and if the museum ceases to stimulate, I'm left with naught but my inner monologue, and little in life terrifies me more than that. Construction quest, what? Construct a museum, he wants me. I don't think that I've ever had this quest before, that they actually want me to build a museum. Alright, and I actually also have only 30 minutes time for this. Yeah, it's possible, of course. Let's go with the trade routes first. So, in Rosario, the good thing is we have 3 iron deposits here. I'm going to build a mine now for all of them. They are going to deliver the iron ore then to the warehouses. That's number 1, number 2, and number 3, which has no... which was very strange because it didn't have anything. And it needs a brick road there to really fully reach something. We're also going to get rid now of the furnaces here. So instead of the furnace, I'm going to have a warehouse here for these iron mines. And what we can now do finally is also getting rid of these factories. So that is something I want to prepare. We do need a route for that. And in that case, a new trade route. And we're going from Rosario to Caton. And in Rosario, we're going to load it with lots and lots of iron ore. In fact, probably, let's go with, 150 tons that we're going to deliver to Caton. And we are going to say then, actually, let's make it 4, right? And put Chiroboa on it. And we do need a second trade route. Now, there is a question again, why would I want to have 2 separate trade routes for that? Well, reason is congestion, of course. If I want to actually do something, like getting 200 tons of ore, I do need 2 ships for that. Otherwise, one will always be full if the harbor is full at some point. So that is my, well, thought process here. We're going with some steel beams, and with some weapons. That is the other trade route. And this trade route here is going to have two ships. The Musk Ox for now, and then I'm going to add another ship once this one has reached Caden. Oh, wait a second. I think we have a ship there. There it is, Hui Kang. And Hui Kang is now on the trade route from the other side. So there we have now finally two new trade routes. So this whole thing is working. The steel is coming to Rosario. And that means that I can finally get rid of these ugly factories. We get a lot of attraction again. We are a fair city now. So not an ordinary city anymore. Gained a bit of attraction there. That is pretty good. Let's also... What do we do with the bakeries? I mean, we could still now expand a bit with the city here, right? There we have our concrete. As we can see, more concrete is coming in now. We have 24 tons already, and they're fully working. That is a good thing. And let's just check also my sewing machine factory. Do we have... Oh, it's actually negative. And the fur coats is positive, though. That's fine. They are negative because they lack some steel. That's right. So the steel should be coming in then now with the new trade routes. Meantime, while we wait on these things, I want to continue developing a bit my Salsa Verde. Now, in Salsa Verde, we have one big advantage. First of all, we have a lot of space in this town. So I think this will be actually my main island, Salsa Verde, because we can really have the biggest city there. Because the other cities are all divided by rivers. Even though rivers are not the worst thing, like Pleasance here, for example. In Pleasance, of course, we have the rum production up and running there. In Salsa Verde, we do have the cotton trade now, but we are also producing the plantain. Well, if my fisheries would be working, there they are. And that means that I could theoretically transport that right to Garden of Sin. So I don't even need that production here, right? I can send that over here. The same with the ponchos, even though the ponchos will probably construct on our own. More ships are under attack. Doesn't really bother me that much. Why does it not bother me? Because, of course, those are just ships passing each other and they're automatically firing them most of the time. So it's not a real attack. That is that. And there seems to be something blocked here. No, that is fine. So Salsa Verde is also growing. Let's have the ponchos here as well. And, oh, wait a second. Do my engineers need the coffee already? Let's just have a quick look there. And the coffee will be unlocked soon, actually. We just need to upgrade a few more guys of them. And then we could go with the coffee right away. Glass as it is what they want right now, though that is, yeah, also quite an expensive thing. And more resources are coming in. I think my steel production is now working too. Ship was destroyed. Oh, there it is. Ship was destroyed down here. And I'm pretty sure that I had... More than ready. I had patrols here, right? There they are. This is very strange once again. Yes. Why? Well,
it's a Pyrrhic victory.
Ah, well, it doesn't matter why the patrols are not there. I'm just building two more ships off the line and we're going to get these patrols up and running. Now, what I want to do here in Salsa Verde is, first of all, we do have the bricks that we can get over there to the Garden of Sin and perhaps... Nah, that's actually it, right? Because we're going to have this Piranha then as a trade route where we get the, well, at least the prior plantain to the Garden of Sin, the ponchos, we probably can make ourselves, right? Beautiful, beautiful village that we create. Or quite a big one, I should say. We have a whole lot of room here as well for that. And those guys, we do have the chapel there. Seeing everything as it is, very good. So fried plantain is the only thing that's really missing there. And we also have pearl and tobacco here. And since that is a really big island, it's pretty incredible, to be honest. We can have, yeah, I think tobacco and coffee completely here. And the pearls, they just need the beaches. So and in that case, yeah, should be a very productive island here, the Garden of Sin. And of course, that also needs a big town. We have that. Cards get oh, and there is a street missing. Righto. Now, ponchos is still something that I like to make. And in that case, as we can see, we got a quite complex river system on this island there. So we should be careful of not using too many bridges there because they are just very expensive and cost a lot of timber. And then we can have a little warehouse. We could also go up to this side there. Oh, yeah, we don't need a bridge for that. I'd rather use that timber than on something. for this clay deposit. Of course, we do need the obrero workforce first. And then here, we can have ourselves a few ponchos. Oh, well, a bit of a poncho production. First of all, we do need some alpaca farms. And who doesn't like some alpacas? Let's have four. And let's have four of these poncho darners then as well. That should, well, be quite enough for quite some time. And yeah, it's my intention, of course, to build quite the town there as well. And then we just need to have these farms there on either side. Of course, I could also just have copied it. But that's still fine. Looking good. I like all these details. Just look at that. We got a little hut there in the center. There's a well or pool where they can probably swim around on hot days. And other than that, yeah, they're going to have a bit of fun over there now. Attractiveness. Attractiveness also increased quite a bit there. Oh, yeah. That's that. So they are starting producing now soon. We might actually go with a whole new district here as well at some point. My piranha has arrived. Let's unload the bricks and build ourselves another cannon tower. And I think in that case, let's have... it's very expensive, in fact. Let's have this one of a blueprint. But two of them should be quite ready fine anyway. And piranha is going to be on a trade route now. And that is going to be, I think, is it the first trade route here in the New World? Between the islands, Salsa Verde, where we're going to, say, take some fried plantains if we still have them here. Oh, we don't have that much of it. Why? Because the fisheries were down, of course. And 50 should be fine. In one of your factories. And we got an explosion. Righto, but we have a fire station here. Let's mobilize our firefighters. And of course, my rum production is halted now. Not a good thing. Not terrible either. But still, going to take a bit of time there for those fires to be doused. That is in Pleasance. Right in Pleasance. Yeah, still plenty of space though as well. We might expand. And we have a second clip already that we can then use. And I just want to check why my fried plantain is so low. The fisheries are working, the fish oil factory. I think it is because we just have a high consumption now too. Plus one, that is definitely too much. So let's have another fish oil factory. In fact, let's have two of them. We have enough bricks to upgrade the warehouse here. That we should do. And then I'm going with two more of these plantations, even though, yeah, we do need to place them a bit more carefully there. Alright, I was there. I was thinking for a second that she would actually have sunk one of our ships there.
Your island is under attack.
Oh, this sounds more serious. The Garden of Sin. Oh, look at that! That is a huge surprise by Miss Hunt. She's just jumping in here with a few of her flagships there. Where are mine? They're patrolling here. Oh my goodness, I did not expect such a large-scale attack there so soon again. We do have the bricks though still. I mean, they're backing off again because I do have two cannons. But she could probably have taken it with the loss of one of these ships. But it would probably have been possible. This is pretty disturbing, to be honest. Let's send my clipper here with the bricks. Then we can finish the next cannon. That is definitely something we should be doing. I think we can even finish then two more of those guys. Very close there, but holy moly, that was close. I can't afford, of course, to lose my Garden of Sin. And she's got quite the ships here. I do have 37 influence. I might just continue building more and more ships of the line. Right, four are now in construction. These four I will send right to the New World then. All my harbors here are good though. And I certainly cannot build more defenses. The problem is I just don't have the influence for all of that. I also need some propaganda there from time to time, which costs ship influence again. In that case, money, yeah, let's go with a bit of money and a bit of minus consumption. And a bit of happiness is there by default. And I'm using some smaller propaganda, so I'm saving a bit of influence there again. But I should someone not spend it right away. That is just not something I should do. And we also have a new plague system, or plague problem. Where's my hospital? It's too far away, yep. Certainly not workable there. Let's have the hospital in this area then, for this whole district. Oh boy, it's very expensive to maintain such a city. And of course, we also have the problem here with the bakeries. I should, well, I don't want to have them there for that much longer. Because I want to, of course, continue with building my city there. Now, Miss Hunt is continuing to annoy me. In that case, she's destroying my fisheries, my fish oil factories. Instead of having them there, we might just choose another harbor for it. But it's the only harbor that I can think of right now. There are the bricks. Oh god, we need to finish this quickly. And there we have the third cannon tower ready, costing me some influence again. And I think we might go with another mounted gun there as well. So this should be quite a nice defense that we have now. Right, but that is still a problem here.
Is under attack.
They have to stay here to defend my clippers going to the old world. So I cannot retreat them. Yeah, we'll just have to take the losses there once again and build them again. But I'm building my ships already for the new world to protect myself. She's getting stronger. She's getting much stronger. That I don't like. Another thing some of you pointed out is that I should purchase more building resources, because usually I don't have that many. So in Rosario we only have 58 bricks, for example, once again, which is not much. So of course King Cole here can be on a trade route. We can also of course have a trade route from Archie, High Clarence Hall, to Rosario. And we can choose, for example, that you take all the bricks and all the steel beams you have and deliver that to Rosario. It's not very expensive building materials. We could do the same thing vice versa then with selling something, but for now, having the building materials coming then into Rosario more often is fine. The problem here is still that we don't have any other clay deposit. So that is something that I will need to do more now in the new world. And I think, yep, the Garden of Sin is a perfect location for that, because we got three clay deposits here. We have a safe corridor with lots of defenses, so it might be a very good attack, well, very good trade route system that we have there. And yeah, she could not defeat my island, that is fine. We have now the ponchos here, and fried plantains are coming in as well. So, oh yep, that's it. We can upgrade the first people here in the Garden of Sin. Let's do this. And then we got more of them. And more. And with that, we have finally now the obrero workforce to afford that for our clay deposits. So that we have the clay deposit, and then of course we do need the brick factories on that as well. And let's try to squeeze them in here. Of course, there's not much space in those areas. We need a bit of timber there as well. I think we have the timber here. That is working though. Yeah, and the workforce is coming in, so we can continue growing this town here into something big. There's the clipper coming in with some fried plantain. It's not much. They have been destroyed again, the fish oil factories. And I cannot do that yet. Island is still under siege. All right. And something very important that we need to do now as well is the commute pier. So we can finally go with that. Look at that. We have 45 tons of reinforced concrete. So I will be able to build the first one, of course, in Catan for now. So we do need one in Rosario and one in Catan. And then we can finally share our workforce, because in Rosario we have plenty with thousands of workforce. And here we barely have anything without the need to continue advancing the city. And I don't want to have Catan to be that big. As well, you know, so in that case, for our commute pier, let's just check what we do need for that. We do need the 30 tons of reinforced concrete, 40 tons of windows. We have so much windows, it's incredible, really. And some steel beams, right? So let's go with the steel beams, the windows, and also the reinforced concrete. Here we'd only need 30 tons of it, and get this one to Catan. Actually, it doesn't even cost any bricks. It makes me wonder, but still, that's fine. And the clipper is now on its way. We have 14,600 people and we have some resources. I might just continue upgrading a few more houses here. And we've also reached a new city status, which is the capital. And since we do have the resources and we do have the quest, should we not just have a museum? I think that might be a nice touch to the whole thing. Up here, we have the space. Or in the middle somewhere, but then we would have to... Yeah, actually, we might have the museum here, because I don't need these guys anymore. I do have the same production in Catan, and I can just deliver that to my area. We will also no longer need then here that warehouse there, right? So instead of those things, let's actually place a few more houses here, but they can also just be a placeholder. have the street and then have the connection. And in this area, small as it may be, but it's a fine space actually, because we can also expand to this area there. We might just have our little museum that my people want. And let's just find it a suitable location. In that regard, this might be fine. Or so. Well, let's have it like that. There we have it. And I can now place those tiles that I need, or the exhibition tiles that I want. Not the pathways or ornaments or something like that. But the exhibition, we can now place them around it, and especially up here as well. Of course, what we should be doing is placing a few of them so that we get a kind of a feeling of what we want to place here. Yes, yes, yes. And I need to connect it, of course. And thus, we should have the finished. Construct a museum module.
As always, I endure.
I couldn't defeat an island of... Oh no, she couldn't defeat an island of yours. Okay. Alright, build a module inside. We don't have anything for that yet.
I feel it reflects the times.
And engineers were onto farms all over the globe as the joint efforts of agriculturalists and engineers culminated in the creation of the tractor. Oh yes, that's right. With the engineers, we have now the tractors available as well. First, we don't need the oil though, so that will be our next goal then. What can these motorized mastodons do for our economy? We expect Ben Phillips will once again chevron a path in the soil for others to follow. So with that, we have the tractors then, and then boost our farms if we want for, yeah, the same space almost, and boost them tremendously, will be good for our economy. Stay tuned.